I like going to the MoMA and the gallery shows and stuff. It seems to be a very exclusive world. Here is bringing art to the street.
The city is its own gallery, from private installations to murals to art that stands alone. One artist makes the city his canvas.
I love New Yorkers. I love just the strength of what it takes to endure.
Hans Horscher has become famous for creating art that doesn't last. His medium is chalk.
I just love the colors themselves. I always try to keep it bright. I start with a yellow to catch the eye.
He softens the chalk in water, changing its consistency and becoming more like paint.
I feel I'm building something here. You know, I call it an installation.
For more than two centuries, Washington Square Park has been one of the city's most densely used green spaces. Adding to its colorful history, a new shade of joy.
If someone takes the time to read this, I want to create a little bit of happiness for them. A general love song to the city of New York.
Horscher has spent the past 7 years painting our streets with notes of optimism, cheer, and love.
You know, your mom used to put notes in your lunchbox to do your best, keep going. I think this is a kind of lunchbox notes for the whole city.
So you're the mom to the city. You're just giving lunchbox notes to everybody.
5-second affirmation, give you that little boost.
He works quick, so fans have to chase him down.
Every Wednesday, I come just to see if you were here.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Nice to meet you. I love your work.
Social media is good for something.
Some artists become more famous with the art that they create and sell in galleries. But the art that you're creating is a gift to anybody that walks by.
That's part of the beauty of it. It's just there for a little while. It's very ephemeral. It will last maybe 3 days until the weather comes and takes it away. At the touch of love, everyone becomes a poet.
Horscher is part poet, part entertainer, and part modern-day street philosopher.
I have written your name on the palm of the universe, for you're the most beautiful of all creation.
His art grabs your attention because his handwriting is perfect. He even earns commission for lettering storefronts and menu boards.
I went to take an aptitude test at school, and it said, I have good qualities of being an artist. I showed my brother, and he said, pick something else. They don't make much money. And today, he's the country's leading psychic. I'm just kidding.
From Washington Square Park to the Upper West Side, his work sprinkles the streets of New York.
I can drop a little inspiration, like Johnny Appleseed, and that's going to blossom. And look, you never know where that grows. I'll never meet all the people that I can influence.
Takes him about 20 minutes to finish. It may only last a few days, but that's enough to inspire.
People come to New York to find themselves. They come to New York to become someone new. New York is the gateway of America's diversity.
What do you hope that people get out of your work?
Just the joy of being alive. Life is meant to be celebrated. Art should bring people together. It's the human experience, really. We as New Yorkers have to have some class and style and be civilized and just look after each other and show the world how it's done.
You've got that kind of spirit in you.
Where there's love, there is life. Here on Valentine's Day, folks. Happy Valentine's, everybody.